production and management of food from plant. Okay, in last classes we discussed about different types of activities and some important points in this chapter, production and management of food from animal. Okay, here food from plant, not animal. Okay, observe different types of crops, short-term crops, long-term crops, like duration of the crop. Okay, next different season, when do crops cultivate? When do crops cultivate actually? Actually, crops are cultivated. Crops are cultivated in different seasons. In different seasons, crops are cultivated in different seasons, like summer season, rainy season, winter season, like this. Okay, now let us discuss about an activity to observe the different types of crops grown in different conditions or seasons. Activity, what is the aim of this activity? To observe the different crops growing in different seasons. Growing in different seasons. Observe carefully. Okay, in this activity, procedure. In this activity, you have to go to nearby village or any village, and you have to ask the farmer to collect the information on this topic. Okay, when do plants or crops grow? Okay, observe, after collecting the information, you have to fill a table like this. Name of the season, like rainy season, winter season, summer season. Okay, next, different types of plants. For example, pulses, next, cereals, observe carefully different types of vegetables. Yeah, like this, there are different types of plants, and crop. After collecting the information from the LS of your village, you have to fill this table. Okay, during the rainy season, winter season, summer season, which type of crop are grown? Which type of crops are grown? Observe one. Observe carefully. Write the different types of pulses in rainy season, next during the winter season, next summer season. Next, cereals in rainy season, winter season, summer. Vegetables in three seasons and fruit in three seasons. Like this, you have to maintain and note down all the boxes based on the information collected from the farmer. Okay, observe carefully. Okay, next. What is the result of this activity? In which season did you observe more number of food material? Understanding, in which season did you observe the more number of vegetables or cereals, pulses, fruits? In which season actually rainy season? During the rainy season, more number of vegetables, cereals, pulses, these are present during the rainy season. What is the reason for this type of condition? During the rainy season, all the aquatic ecosystem are pulled by water. All aquatic ecosystem fulfilled by all aquatic ecosystems are fulfilled by rain water, and more water is available. More water is available in this season. That is why different types of plants are grown and variety of food items are appear during the rainy season, because each and every aquatic ecosystem can be fulfilled with the water. Okay, this is a very important one, rainy season. Here, plants which are grown in rainy season or crops which are grown in rainy season, they are called Kharif season. That is called actually Kharif season. Entire this Kharif season means June to October, Kharif season. During the Kharif season, only some plants are grown. For example, rice, sugarcane, sugarcane, these are the Kharif crops which are grown in Kharif season. Are called kharif crop. In Arabic language, in Arabic language, kharif means rain. In Arabic language, kharif kharif means rain. Okay, observe. Actually, crops are cultivated in different seasons. Already we discussed about crops. What are crops? What are crops? Crops means plants which are grown. Plants which are grown in large number to get the different types of useful material. Okay, they are called crops. Those plants are called crop plants. Okay, here different types of crops are cultivated in different seasons. Okay, to observe the different types of the crops in different seasons, we have to perform an activity. What is the aim of this activity? What is the aim of this activity? To observe the different crops growing in different seasons. This is the main aim of this activity. Next procedure, how to go to the village and how to ask different types of doubts and questions to farmers and collect the information of growing of different crops in different season. Okay, how to collect the different crops growing in different season. Okay, also now here how to fill or how to place the different crops in appropriate all these boxes. Rainy season, winter season, summer season. Pulses, cereals means, for example, rice, barley, wheat. These are the cereals. Vegetable fruit. Now also after this experiment, you have to say some answers for questions. In which season did you observe more number of food materials or products? Actually, we can observe the in rainy season. In rainy season, we can rainy season we can observe more number of vegetables, fruits, pulses, cereals, any other plant material. What is the reason for that? What is the reason? During the rainy season, all aquatic ecosystems are fulfilled by water. More water is available in this season. Okay, understanding. In this season, which season? Rainy season is also called as Kharif season. What? Kharif season. Crops which are grown in rainy season, they are called Kharif crops. They are called usually Kharif crops. Okay. Here observe Kharif crop, for example, rice, sugarcane, next to green gram. Okay, these are the Kharif crop. Next observe, here Kharif season means June to October. Next, in Arabic language, Kharif means rice. Okay, observe once again. Actually, during the Kharif season, more varieties of vegetables are available in market when compared to these three, more varieties of vegetables are available. Okay, during the Kharif season. Yes, next. Next if you observe the table conducted in last table of the last activity or previous activity, you can observe more number of sterile pulses fruit in winter season. Okay, fruits in winter season. In winter season, we can observe more number of sterile pulses and other one, pulses, sterile fruits. We can observe more number of these type of crops during the winter season. During the winter season, these type of crops are grown. Actually, winter season, water availability is low. Water availability is low. Water availability is low. Means these type of crops require less water. These crops require low amount of water. Yes. This is important, remember, low amount of water. These type of crops which are grown in winter season are called rabi crop. These are called usually rabi crop. Less amount of water when compared to the plants or crops grown in Kharif season. Here in Arabic language, Rabi means winter. Rabi means winter. Okay, this is a very important one. Here different types of plants are grown during the winter season. For example, wheat, barley, maize, fenugreek, like these different types of crops are grown as rabi crop. Okay, this is a very important one. Rabi crop. Actually, rabi season mein October to February or March. Okay, to February, from February to time here, October to March or April. Kharif season, May, June to September or October. Okay, this is the year. Duration of Rabi season. Observe one. Yes, observe. Winter season, important season, this is the rabi Ravi season. In Arabic, Ravi means winter. The different types of pulses, cereals, fruits are grown during the winter season. Here, water availability is low during the winter season. Means these type of crops require low amount of water. Example, wheat, barley, maize, fenugreek, coriander, and this number of plants. Okay, this is the October to March, April. This is the season. Kharif season, June to October. Okay, June to October. Now observe production. Production of crops is dependent on the flowering process. Production of crops is dependent on the production of the crop is dependent on the flowering process. Flowering is very, very important for the production of the crop. If there is no flowering, there will be no grains, fruits, any other words. That is why flowering is very, very important one. After several experiments on this flowering process, scientists stated that there are different types of reasons for the flowering. There are some different types of effects. Reasons for the flowering. What are these? First one is flowering. Flowering process. It is actually after certain growth. It is dependent on the growth. After a certain growth of plant, the flowering process is occurred. For example, certain height of the plant or formation of few leaves, for example 7 to 9 leaves, or internode. After formation of some internode or some leaves, or after growth of a certain height, like this, after certain period of time, flowering process occurs in plant. When we sow a seed inside of the soil, okay, under favorable conditions, it is germinated, forming a small plantlet. Okay. Can plantlet produce flowers? No. Plantlet grows continuously up to certain for